Today, we are going to look at a BodyViz brain builder about the female reproductive system and polycystic ovarian syndrome. According to the National Institute of Health, approximately 7 to 10% of women are affected with polycystic ovarian syndrome. In this brain builder, we will discuss the anatomy of the ovaries, as well as the symptoms, possible causes, and treatment options for PCOS. Firstly, let's talk about the incredible anatomy of the ovaries. These small, paired organs within the female pelvic cavity play a vital role in reproductive health. Although rare, some individuals are born with just one ovary, and a select few even have a supernumerary ovary. The position of the ovaries is variable, especially during pregnancy, but each ovary is located within an ovarian fossa. The ovarian fossae are depressions of the posterolateral aspects of the pelvic cavity, with each ovary being located on each side of the pelvic cavity. Bordering the ovaries are the iliac arteries. The external iliac artery is superior to the ovary, and the internal iliac arteries are inferior to the ovaries. Connective tissue structures, known as ligaments, contribute to maintaining the structural integrity of the ovaries. The mesovarium links the ovary to the posterior aspect of the broad ligament. Between the mesovarium and the pelvic wall's lateral aspect lies the suspensory ligament. Additionally, the ovary is tethered to the lateral uterine wall by the round ligament. The ovary's outer layer, termed the surface epithelium or germinal epithelium, is encompassed by the peritoneum. The underlying tunica albuginea is a thin, fibrous capsule. The ovary's cross-section displays an inner medulla and an outer cortex. The medulla houses connective tissue, lymphatics, blood vessels, and nerves, while the cortex contains compact connective tissue with ovarian follicles at different stages. Ovarian follicles progress through primordial, primary, secondary, and mature stages, each marked by distinct developments. Mature follicles, the largest, span the cortex, preparing for potential ovulation. Histological analysis reveals follicular atresia, degeneration occurring at various stages. A female is thought to have all of her oocytes at birth, with ovulation alternating between ovaries, and typically only one follicle ovulation per cycle. Next, we will look at the symptoms, causes, and treatments for polycystic ovarian syndrome, and then give a patient example. Polycystic ovarian syndrome, or PCOS, is one of the leading causes of female infertility. Females with PCOS experience a hormonal imbalance and metabolic issues that can potentially affect the individual's long-term health. Symptoms of polycystic ovarian syndrome can start around the first menstrual period or later in life. The symptoms of PCOS can vary considerably. In order to make a positive diagnosis for PCOS, a female will typically have the following symptoms: abnormal menstrual periods that are irregular in duration or frequency, ovaries that are abnormally large or have numerous cysts, and exhibit raised levels of androgen. There are many additional symptoms that may occur, as well as symptoms that appear due to PCOS being left untreated, such as the following. PCOS is complex and multiple factors can cause the condition, although the exact underlying cause is not fully understood. However, PCOS often develops when a female is unable to ovulate. This can cause many small cysts within the ovary, and these cysts produce androgenic hormones, which can further disrupt the menstrual cycle. These androgenic hormones may also contribute to many other symptoms that go along with PCOS. Treatment is determined based on a few different factors, such as the patient's age, the severity of the symptoms, the patient's overall health, and whether or not the patient wishes to become pregnant. For patients that don't want to become pregnant, treatment options can include birth control pills, diabetes medication, and changes in diet and activity. If a patient does wish to become pregnant, the treatment options will often include medications to enhance ovulation and changes in diet and activity level, which can help the body use insulin more effectively, lower blood glucose levels, increase the ovary's ability to ovulate, and reduce the severity of PCOS symptoms. Fortunately, PCOS can be successfully treated. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example. You receive your patient's file and take a look. Age, 28, sex, female. Chief complaints? Irregular periods, excessive hair growth, and weight gain. you invite the patient into your office for an examination. Your patient describes irregular periods, increased facial and body hair, and weight gain. Your assessment and blood tests confirm PCOS, marked by elevated androgens and insulin resistance. With a diagnosis in place, you can discuss a personalized plan. You recommend hormonal therapy for menstrual regularity and a combination of oral contraceptives and anti-androgen medications to manage hirsutism. Lifestyle changes, including diet and exercise, will help address insulin sensitivity and weight. You explain to your patient that the treatment for PCOS will be ongoing lifestyle changes, but with dedication, PCOS can be treated successfully. This is an example of PCOS. Thank you for watching this Brain Builder video. Please like and subscribe to our BodyViz channel, or if you are new at BodyViz, check out our other anatomy resources and schedule a demo at bodyviz.com.